my goodness, Tracy Morgan, welcome back.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
You look very, very. It's a very interesting look. I love what's going on here.
I'm competing. What you think?
You're in the Olympics?
Yeah.
But oh my gosh! Them, congratulations.
I called him and told him I wanted my medals now before I get to Paris, because I'm selling these. I'm from the streets.
So you get your medals before you even go to the Olympics.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh! You look fantastic. Are you training right now?
Training? What it look like? I'm in the best shape of my life.
What?
I'm competing in a conditioned roast beef contest. They try to disqualify me from roast beef, but somebody got some money.
Yeah. A conditioned roast beef contest? Oh, my God.
It's a new event.
I love that.
I started it.
Kanish and also roast beef. Now, you might actually bring home the gold. I feel
I thrilled. Think I'm bringing home the gold.
That's what I think, too.
I think I'm bringing home the gold.
Well, you know why, though?
Either that, either I'm going to bring home the gold or a female from Paris.
All right, one or the other. Yeah, one or the
Somebody's
other.
Somebody's getting pregnant.
Yeah, okay. Hey, can I show you a photo of something that this is for real? This is Tracy Morgan back in high school.
That's me, Action Jackson.
Look at that. Action Jackson. Where is this?
That's the hurdles.
Yeah.
Yeah, I ran in high school. I ran a 100-meter dash and a 200-meter dash.
Dude, look at you.
And my fastest time in a 100-meter dash was a 10.45 with Kanishas in front of me. You know I love Kanishas, right?
Yeah,
I love Kanishas and hot dogs from off Fifth Avenue.
Yeah.
That's where Howard Cosell used to buy his Franks.
I'm here getting my Kanishas.
I don't call them hot dogs, I call them Franks.
Yeah. Do you call them beef Franks? No.
Franks.
Just Franks.
Gotta be kosher.
Yep.
Yes.
Last time we were on, we talked about how you started dating right now, and I just wanna know, how's it going? Have you met anyone special? Or?
I'm different, Jimbo. I'm an unusual dude. Most men want a woman who got themselves together, got a good job, got a degree. Not me, Jim. I'm looking for a woman who's almost falling apart. It's just about done.
Really?
Yes, she's just about done. I'm her one-stop shop. Don't cheat yourself, treat yourself.
There you go.
Call Trey Barry.
That's what I'm talking about. Don't cheat yourself. Treat yourself.
If it's just about falling apart.
Call Trey Bag.
Yeah.
Tracy, you're a great comedian, but you're also a entrepreneur. You were telling me backstage that you started a new business.
Mm-hmm. I started an OnlyFans page.
Oh, this is smart.
I started OnlyFans. You get to see me in my boxes with my New York Knick hat on. But if you want to see my feet, especially after the accident, it's going to run you another $19.99.
Okay, all right, yeah, I understand. Now you, I'll do it. We're in the middle of an unprecedented heat wave here in New York.
Oh, good it is. It's hot out there, y'all.
It is hot. I mean, it's...
It is hotter than my father's scrotum pouch. You know how hot it was swimming around in his pouch as a sperm cell? It was hot. And I live in an affluent neighborhood in New Jersey. I live in and I turned a fire hydrant on in my neighborhood, and my neighbors came out. And they said, "What's going on, Tracy? Is there fire?" I said, "Yes, in my pants."
Are you,
Somebody getting pregnant.
All right, now look, are you,
I love my babies.
Are you,
I love my babies, man.
Are you...
You know how many kids I got?
I think so.
Off the books or on the books? got a lot of kids off the books, man. I'm old school. I don't pull out. Okay. I'm old school. I don't play.
All right.
I make babies.
All right, now let's sit and look. We don't have to change the subject, but...
And I'm a good father.
I know you are.
I come around every 10 years. Just to tell them I'm your daddy.
That is nice.
Is your mom upstairs?
That is thoughtful. That is thoughtful of you.
I got kids out there.
Yeah, half our audience. Stand up if you're one of Tracy's kids.
Stand up and say hi
to dad.
Daddy.
There you go, there you go. There's a couple there.
Junior.
There you go.
Junior.
There's Junior right there.
I told told Junior not to wear that shirt.
You told him not to wear it. He wore it anyway.
But that's my baby, though.
That's your baby right there.
That's my baby.
Came to see the
show. Got that beard. That's my baby.
That's right. Came to see it tonight.
Almost 40.
Is that right? Happy birthday.
I'm giving everybody another big wheel.
Happy birthday.
Went through a whole box of Captain Crunch yesterday.
Did he? The whole by himself. What is his name?
Jeff.
Jeff Morgan.
I call him Jay Boogie.
Yeah, Jay Boogie. Tracy, what are you doing this summer? Let's talk about this. Are you staying in, are you going on vacation? Are you staying in
I'm around one of my daughters out to Disney World.
Oh, that's great.
I'm so glad I'm able to take and treat my kids this way.
Yeah.
You know? Because when I was younger, my father said, we're going to see Mickey.
Yeah.
But it was just some dude that owed him money.
Oh, yeah, that's different.
He had four teeth and two of those was in his pocket.
Oh, you're going to go take you to see Mickey.
I got an uncle that gets hit by cars professionally.
Oh, that's nice.
He's on crack.
I got to meet him one day.
Yeah.
I was Googling you before the show, and there's a lot of facts in there that I don't know is real. And this is, I'm not doing a bit.
Before you go on with this bit, is there any police in here? I don't want nothing now.
No. But this is...
Not your limitation.
Because I'm actually learning a little bit about you, and I've known you for years, but these are some facts I saw on the internet I don't know are true or not true. And honestly, I know you pretty well. I don't know the answers to this. Is this true or false? You have an Oscar in your home, despite the fact you've never won or been nominated for an Oscar. Is that true?
Somebody snitching. Somebody snitching.
You have an Oscar? Do you know who...
Somebody snitching.
How did you end? Do you know how you have an Oscar in your house?
Don't worry about
it. Okay, all right.
Don't you worry
about
it.
I'm not gonna do it. I'm not gonna worry about it. That's fantastic. Can I ask you a question? Is that baby powder?
It's for the Olympics, Jim. As soon as I leave here, I'm going out to Paris.
I know,
I gotta get ready.
But I think they put like rosin on their hands or something. I don't think
they put baby powder.
They do.
Yeah, sometimes they put flour.
Is it really?
Yes.
I didn't know any of this.
I'm trying to tell you, it's my fourth Olympics. I know.
Before becoming a comedian, is it true that your mom wanted you to work at UPS?
Yes, she said they had benefits and good outfits.
That's
and
true.
I wanted the brown shorts. So I worked at UPS.
Did you really?
Yes.
I didn't ever know this.
Yes, I got fired, man. I got the supervisor pregnant.
Can I ask you something, who was here the other day? But you got your start as Hustle Man in Martin Lawrence.
Yeah.
On Martin, this is true. This is you as, look at this. Come on, young Tracy, Hustle Man. Dude, I remember that. Did Martin give you your start?
Well, he didn't give me my start. My start started a long time ago.
Yeah.
My start started in 1968, when my mother's water broke. That's when hit the fan. I came out the womb funny.
He did, yeah. Did Martin get along? Did you get along with Martin?
I love my mother. I didn't think he liked me at first because when I was on Def Jam and he gave me the mic, I slapped him on the butt. Mm. It was a great pass. We didn't drop the mic.
That was
then
it.
2 months later, he called me back and asked me to be on the show, and I realized and found out that he loved me. And I love him, too. I love you, Martin.
Oh, come on. I saw you that. There's a picture of you at the Bad Boys premiere right there. I mean, you've known Martin for a long time.
That's my OG.
He's a genius.
And Will is my OG, too.
Yeah, he's brilliant.
I'm right in the middle. That's a lot of manpower right there.
It is a lot.
That's a lot of funny.
That's a lot of funny right there.
Right there.
Speaking of funny, you were doing the New York Comedy Festival. I think we did this festival once years ago together, me and you, November 15th.
I think we did.
The New York Comedy Festival.
Yeah.
I'm
telling jokes and selling coke, you know.
That's not true.
That's what the festival's about.
That's
right?
Not what the festival's about. But you were.
So if you get high, come on out and have a laugh.
You're one of the funniest comedians I've ever met in my
life. Who? Me?
Yes.
Yeah, right.
I swear, I would give you a gold medal for being the funniest comedian. Can I just take one of those?
Funny.
Can I take one of those medals?
I'm funny. You know, I went to the this past, I went to the, what do you call it, a horse race? The Kentucky Derby.
Were you there?
I was there.
I didn't see you.
I thought I saw you there. It was, you got a twin. You got a hopper-dinger. I look just like you.
Doppelganger.
A doppelganger, whatever you call that. Yeah. Whatever you, I got to go back to high school. My grandmother told me when I was on Saturday Night Live, I should go back and get my GED. I said, Grandma, I'm on Saturday Night Live. I made it already.
I'm on TV.
I went to the Derby. To Kentucky Derby.
Wow.
And they kicked me out.
What?
Because I tried to put 400 on Seabiscuit. And they said, he's no longer with us, sir. I said, what? When did this happen? I wanted to bet on Secretariat. They said, he's not long with us.
Yeah, yeah, unbelievable. You're getting bad tips.
I had fun.
You did have fun?
Yeah. I was with, what's his name, the kid?
Travis Kelce?
Yeah, I was with him. I was hanging out with everybody.
You were?
I seen Beyonce's mother was there.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's right. Beautiful.
She is.
I want to get her pregnant. Everybody I meet want to get pregnant.
My mom met Beyonce's mom on Letterman. They did a
Mother's cool Day. People.
Yeah.
Cool people, all right.
They did a thing where it was Mother's Day and every mom came out and told a joke. And so every Beyonce's mom came out, Lance Armstrong's mom came out, someone else's mom came out and told jokes, and then my mom came out and told the joke. And then Letterman goes over and gives a rose to every mom.
Ooh,
and
he goes, I'd have been there booing people. You know I went to a Michael Jackson concert and booed him? So he started doing the moonwalk. I said, boo, boo, we already saw it, boo. Do something different.
You booed Michael Jackson and said, we already saw that. We already saw the moonwalk. Why would you? you would say, but boo, we already saw
Joe, his father, Joe, gave Bubbles a beating. He pooped on the living room floor and he whooped his behind. He said, you see what I did, Tito? Gave him a beer.
Yeah.
You saw the new Planet of the Apes?
No, I didn't see the new.
I love Planet of the Apes because my lady's Dominican. And she said I'm toxic because I watch too much monkey movie. She don't call it Planet of the Apes. She call it monkey movie.
What are the
You watch the monkey movie.
No, I like the old Planet of the Apes.
I like the old one, too. That was my uncle, Charlton Heston.
Charlton Heston is your uncle?
Call him Uncle Chuck.
Wow, I didn't
know. Chucky Hess.
Yeah. I like the bad.
Y'all just listening to us?
I like the makeup they used to wear in the old Planet of the Apes because it sounded like a rubber mask.
All my life I awaited your coming and dreaded it. The Forbidden Zone was once a paradise. Your breed made a desert of it ages ago.
I always love having you on the show. Congratulations on your gold medals and good luck. I don't even have to say good luck. You already won your gold medals in the Olympics. There he is, Olympian, Paris Olympian, USA, Tracy Morgan, everybody. Check out tracymorgan.com for tickets to see him on tour. Stick around. We'll be right back, everybody.